Holy God and Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for life. We thank you for peace, Lord, and we thank you for your provision. As we come to you in this troubled time, Lord, I pray for all those, Lord, who are going through bereavement, that you would sustain them, God, and give them peace, Lord, that you would comfort their hearts, that they've not been able to say goodbye to those that they would want to say goodbye to in their own way, Lord, in their special way, given the times that we are allotted. But I pray that you would be with them. I pray for all those, God, who are worried about jobs or change of family circumstances due to this COVID-19. We pray for peace. We pray that you would give them prosperity, Lord, that you would be with them, Lord, and you would sustain them. We thank you that we still have the privilege, Lord, of lifting up your name and giving honor and glory to you, even though all the churches are shut down. But we pray, God, that you would allow us, Lord, to come together and be united as one. And do, Lord, as the Bible said, that we would have all things common. I pray for those who do not know God, who are worried at this time, Lord, that you would open their eyes, Lord, and that through the doors of the church, Lord, that they would enter in and they would look, Lord, to find a God that loves them, a God that understands them, a God who will provide for them. We ask, God, that you would be with us all. You would bless us. I pray that you will bless this service, Lord, that somehow, Lord, through the message, Lord, that your Holy Spirit would enter the doors and windows of the houses, Lord, of those that are listening, that you would touch the lives of the mothers, the fathers, the children's. We look to you, Lord, and pray that your Spirit would be them. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hi, everyone. I just wanted to encourage somebody today that during these difficult times, may your struggles keep you near the cross. May your troubles show that you need God, and may your battles end the way that they should. And may your bad days prove that God is good. May your struggles keep you near the cross. May your troubles show that you need God, and may your battles end the way they should, and may your bad days prove that God is good. May your whole life prove that God is good. May your struggles keep you near the cross. And may your troubles show that you need God. And may your battles end the way they should. And may your bad days prove that God is good. May your whole life prove that God is good. May your struggles keep you near the cross, and may your troubles show that you need God, and may your battles end the way they should, and may your bad days prove that God is good. May your whole life prove that God is good. God bless you.
Hello, my name is Gary. Today's scripture is taken from Colossians 3, 1-17, reading from the New International Version. Here, Paul gives further instructions to the Colossians to living as those made alive in Christ. Since then, you have been raised with Christ. Set your hearts on things above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things, for you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Put to death, therefore, whatever belongs to your earthly nature: sexual immorality, impurity, lust, evil desires and greed, which is idolatry. Because of these, the wrath of God is coming. You used to walk in these ways in the life you once lived. But now you must also rid yourselves of all such things as these: anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language from your lips. Do not lie to each other, since you have taken off your old self with its practices and have put on the new self, which has been renewed in the knowledge in the image of its creator. Here there is no Gentile or Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave or free, but Christ is all and is in all. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another if any of you has a grievance against someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you were called to peace. And be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Amen. Thank you and God bless. Please enjoy the rest of the service.
Hello, I'm so glad you're able to join us today. Our theme this week is laying aside what impairs us. Firstly, I just want to share the definition of impair: to make worse or less effective. Let me share an experience I had a few years back when I parked the car outside my house after coming back from grocery shopping. There was no one home. There were quite a lot of shopping bags, and for some reason I decided to try and take all the shopping bags inside all at once. So I loaded up my hands to bring them into the house. I also had my front door keys in my right hand. As well as all that, I also had some rubbish in my hand from the car to throw in the wheelie bin by the front door. Still holding on to the bags, I struggled to open the bin. I attempted to throw the rubbish in, and guess what happened? Yep, my front door keys followed the rubbish into the bin. I was none too pleased as I heard the clinking of the keys as they made their way to the bottom of the bin. The bin was full of rubbish, but the only way inside was with the key. I braced myself as I was going to have to retrieve the keys from the bin. I had to put everything down that I was loaded up with to retrieve the key. In my desperation, I had to turn the bin on its side and get a stick to reach down into the bottom of the bin in my attempts to retrieve the keys. It wasn't pleasant. It was mucky and smelly. Only God knows what people were thinking as they walked by, watching me rummage through my wheelie bin. In my head, I could hear the words, "If you had made two trips, then you would have saved yourself from this unnecessary, embarrassing experience, and you would have been inside a lot quicker." God has a strange way to use our everyday life experiences to speak to us. After getting inside the house, I reflected on what had just happened, and God, as he does, began to speak to me. He started by saying that I was so loaded down with stuff in my life that I couldn't see clearly in front of myself. He began to reveal this stuff weighing me down may seem as very important stuff in that moment, but some of it was impairing not only my vision, but also impairing my ability to function well. When we are trying to carry too much stuff, it affects our ability to operate as purposefully as we would like to. Remember, the word impair means to make worse or less effective. Does your life sometimes feel like that? Some of this stuff is represented by a lot of the negative things that we have held from our past, and also stuff in our current situations. Hurts, especially from those close to us. Our mistakes, disappointments, failures, worry and anxiety, to name a few. I was trying to carry too many bags, which contributed to my keys ending up where they shouldn't have. When we are carrying excessive stuff, it could mean that we inadvertently throw away key things that God has placed in our hands to open doors he has prepared for us to walk through. God was saying to me, there are unnecessary things you are carrying, unforgiveness to others and yourself, unresolved issues that you keep sweeping under the carpet instead of addressing them, and they are impairing you. Sometimes we can become swamped with guilt and subsequently low self-esteem because we blame ourselves for the way things have ended up. They can cause us to lose hope, and consequently we see things through a negative lens. God wants us to be full of faith, hope, and love as we live out our lives here so that we can be impactful, not impaired. The scripture read in Colossians today is telling us to get rid of the old man and his ways. It's warning us to let go of the stuff that is weighing us down and turn our focus back to God by choosing to follow his commands as we live this new life in Christ. In conclusion, Hebrews 12:1 encourages us, therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Once we choose to let go of what impairs us and live as Colossians 3:1-17 instructs us to, by making God our priority, then we can live fulfilling lives. Always remember, God has promised never to leave us and has provided us a helper in the Holy Spirit so that we can be victorious. Submit to God as the Holy Spirit reveals the stuff in this moment that you need to lay aside that is impairing you. Every blessing.
Thank you.
Thank you to everyone joining us today. This is the time in our service where we worship in giving, our tithes and offerings. Here are the details if you would like to join us. The account name is the Church of God of Prophecy. The sort code is 600902. And the account number is 29382254. Thank you and God bless.
Joining us. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you today for all that you have done for us. We thank you that we can have this opportunity to worship together. Lord, we thank you for this virtual platform, oh Father, where we can come together in many areas, from many different backgrounds, from many different places. Oh Father, we thank you because you are great. Lord, you give us knowledge, you give us wisdom, oh Father, and we thank you for all that you have done. And even in these times, oh God, that we live in, they are uncertain times. Lord, they're times that, oh Father, we could be full of fear if it was not for the love of God. So today, as we listen to your words, I pray you will open up our hearts and our minds to hear from you, to be strengthened by your word, oh God, by this words of encouragement that will be said. Oh Father, we pray that, Lord, oh Father, that you would give us strength for another day. Oh God, and as we go through our week, that we will look to you for direction and guidance and for protection. Father, so many things are happening at this moment. Lord, we are going into another lockdown. Father, we do not know what our future holds. Oh Father, the leaders of the countries, oh Father, they're in turmoil, oh Lord. But I pray today that you will give them direction. Lord, oh Father, you never change. Your words never change. You stand firm forever. I pray, oh God, that they will look to you, oh Father, the rock of our salvation, and ask for your direction in everything they do. Oh God, I pray, oh Father, for our community at this time, that you will protect and keep us, that the numbers, oh Father, of people that are being infected by this virus, oh God, will be reduced, oh Lord, to nothing. Lord, we look to you, because we have no other help but you. And we ask that you will let us hear your words today as we worship. Let us lift our hands, Lord, and be like Job and said that, oh Lord, in the good times or in the bad times, I will worship thee. Oh Father, he said, oh Lord, he come into this world with nothing, and oh Father, he will leave with nothing. So blessed be the name of the Lord, because you hold everything in your hands. I thank you now, in Jesus' name.
We do hope that you've enjoyed the service wherever you are, and we do hope that you have been blessed. If you require prayer or someone to talk to, please, please get in touch. Telephone us on 01452 382 906. You can leave a message, a comment on Facebook, YouTube. Please remember to like us, subscribe to us, share with your family and friends. Spread the word that we are here. And remember to click on the little bell for the notification reminders. That just shows you when we're online. Local church family, please remember to join the Zoom fellowship meeting, and the details will be sent in the usual way. Finally, we would like to encourage you all to remain connected with one another and just to love one another. Remember, stay blessed. Stay positive, stay safe. God bless you, and we will see you soon.